Headed to the gym. Man. I was actually supposed to. Well, I wasn't supposed to, but I was going to go yesterday. Yesterday was a rest day, but I was going to go anyways. My legs were still a little bit sore. So, like I said, right now I'm prioritizing legs, mainly quads. I'm really trying to get my quads to grow. What happened here? So, yeah. I took a rest day yesterday. And now I'm going today so I can hit legs. So this is technically my first leg day of the week. So I'll hit pure. I'm sorry, I'm getting my days mixed up. Yeah. This is my first leg day of the week. So I'll hit hams and quads. And then my second leg day of the week, I hit just quads. But take y'all through a little ham and quad session. I like to start out with my hamstrings first. So I'll start out with like a leg curl. This gym, I wish that they do have a seated leg curl, but I do not like their seated leg curl. It's one of the ones that have like the shin pad. And it just feels so uncomfortable for me, and I don't feel it in my hamstrings at all. So I would just way rather, I don't know, what is going on here? Oh, she setting out signs. Yeah, I guess she's setting out signs right here. Hey, I feel you, girl. Yeah, go on, do your thing, girl. I thought that she was setting out signs. Maybe she's taking them up. But, going to hit this leg day. Ham and quads is the first leg day of my of the week for me. Like I said, I'm prioritizing legs right now, so it just depends on how I'm feeling. So, say today, because today technically could be a chest day, like my chest day, my push day. But since my legs are recovered now, I'm just going to go ahead and hit legs. Because that's my priority body part. So pretty much whenever my legs are good to go again, no matter what day it's supposed to be, I hit legs again. I go off of how well I'm able to recover, which like my recovery has definitely improved, especially since I've just kind of been smarter about my training. I've been smarter about taking my recovery more seriously, just getting in like more of a set schedule for myself, having more like predictability in my schedule. So yeah, but right now I love my leg training has been going really good. I've still been able to be intense while being able to recover and not have to lift like crazy stupid heavy weight, and also not worried about getting injured as much. But yeah, let's get this leg day under wraps. That's what a lot of people think. They think like you gotta like lift super, super heavy to be able to grow a body part. And that's not necessarily the case. Like pick workouts that you can feel and that feel good. Like don't pick workouts just based off of what other people say are great workouts. I mean, you gotta work with what you got to choose what works for you. And I'll show y'all today like some of the exercises that I like personally for my legs, and I've seen a lot of progress with for my legs. But ever since I took a break from training, my legs are always the first thing that downsizes. If I'm training like regularly, then like I could get my legs to grow. But once I like take a break from training, or I stop training like as intensely, whatever, my legs shrink up first. So now that I'm like getting back into the routine, training with intensity, like eating regularly, that's a big part of it too, because I'm naturally not a big eater. So when it comes to me eating, I'm normally just the type of person to I'm content on not eating that much. I could probably eat like two meals a day and be fine. but for muscle building, that's not ideal. So once I get back to, you know, training regularly, my eating also comes back to, you know, eating to build muscle. So that's a big part of it as well. But yeah, let's get this, gonna get this workout out the way and see y'all at the gym. All right, so starting off this leg day with some calves. We're gonna do calves first, standing calf raises. I've noticed that those have always worked better for me than machine calf raises. So I like to do, or not machine, but seated calf raises. So I'll either do like the standing calf raises or I'll do like the hip loaded calf raises. Today I'm gonna do some standing, just like regular machine calf raises. And then after that, we'll go into hamstrings, but I do calves first just because to stretch out my calves for one, because my ankle mobility is not the best. And when it comes to squatting deep, you need good ankle mobility. So I do this to loosen up my calves, and then also my calves are a weak area. So trying to get those to grow. So I want to prioritize those first in my workout. And after that, we'll get into hamstrings and yeah, the rest of the leg day. That was actually pretty light. Alright, so this is the last set. This is two sets, this third set.
I've been doing a down set every time.
So
started out with
two plates. Honestly,
two plates is a little too heavy.
You probably should do like a plate with maybe a 35.
But yeah.
Started out with two plates and then
went to a plate
and a quarter. And now I'm going with just one plate. And I'm really focusing on like the eccentric part of the motion.
Just like really
stretch out the calves.
Calves
tend to grow better whenever like in a stretch position. So I'm just making sure that I really focus on that. Yeah.
All right, got leg curl,
right here, seated leg curl. I'm gonna do mile rep matches on this set. So basically that means that
I'm going to start out, give like a weight that I could do about 10 to 20 reps with. That'll
be my top set. And then I'm going to keep that weight the same and then match the reps for the consecutive sets after that, no matter how many rest breaks it takes. So if I have to take 5 rest breaks to get to the same 20 reps, then that's what I'm going to do. It was a good little warm up. I'm actually already feeling pretty warm from the calves, so it's not gonna take me much to warm up on here. Also, for my warm-ups, I just do like 3 to 4 reps, you know, until like just really focusing on making sure I'm getting good form, making sure that everything is feeling good. But there's no point of like coming out here and doing 10 reps and just wasting energy on, you know, sets that aren't gonna help you grow. Because only the sets that you're taking to failure or close to failure are the ones that are gonna help you grow. A little warm-up sets, doing like 20, 30 reps on those to get warmed up, like you don't need that much. Just do 4 or 5 reps, and if you need multiple sets, do multiple sets, really focusing on form. Or if you like really, really need, if it's leg day and you really need to warm up, like do the bike or something before, just to get your legs warm. But don't come to the machine or whatever you're doing to do 40 reps, because you're just gonna, it's just junk volume at that point. You're not really getting any benefit from that. All right, this is probably the last warm-up set right here. Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's the last warm-up. So another question I get a lot is, how long should you rest? It really just depends. Like, it's very individual based. I don't like to set rest times unless like people, you know, they chronically take too long of a rest or too short of a rest, which most of the time, honestly, they take too short of a rest. Like, especially if you're hitting legs, like legs is a big muscle group. There's no way you should only be resting like 30 to 60 seconds in between a set. Unless you just got like outstanding cardio. But other than that, I say at least like 2-3 minutes between the set to like really be able to give the set your all afterwards. But I just rest until like I get my cardiovascular system back and I got my breath back, and then I'm right into the next set. So that's just a good rule of thumb. If you're still breathing hard, you should probably rest a little bit longer. But if you're getting like cold and not like in the workout anymore, you should probably rest a little bit shorter. That's a good rule of thumb to have. But here we go, second set.
See, that took 3 rest breaks to get the same 11 reps. So, that's what mile rep matches. It doesn't matter how many breaks it takes. You match the same amount of reps each time. So I know this next set, I'm about to have to take like 5-6 rest breaks. But I mean, that's a goal. Keep the weight the same. Keep intensity up, still keep good form. Like, I feel like my form on this one was a lot better than the first one, just because that's why it took me more rest breaks. But good rule of thumb is slow and controlled. Like, just control the movement. You don't have to go like 10 seconds eccentric phase or 10 seconds like, you know, lowering the weight or whatever. Just make sure that you're controlling it on the way down. And whether that's, you know, 2 seconds, 3 seconds, 4 seconds, however long. I think a lot of people just overthink lifting weights, and it's not complicated at all. But it can be, like, if you make it complicated, it can be for sure. All right, last set. I'm gonna really have to push on this one. I already feel it. Here we go. Come on, let's go. Seven. Got 4 more. There you go. Two more.
Yeah, that was rough. I ain't even gonna lie. So the important thing on this one is to make sure you're keeping your form. Because like it's easy, especially on that third set, it took me so many rest breaks, but it's easy to just like kind of cheat the reps and cheat the form because you're just trying to get done. Keep the form the same. Keep the reps consistent as well. All right, let's go to the next one. All right, here we go. Top set. I'm trying to shoot for like 10 to 20 right here. Yeah. 11 reps, that's not bad, but I wanted to try to get like 15, but that's pretty good. I kind of felt my form going at the end. Like I started kind of using more of my like back to get the weight up. So I'm happy with that. 11. I think my last workout, I'll look at my log, but I got like 13 on my last one. So not as good, but not every workout you're gonna match the reps. So it's fine. All right, so like I said, I'm already pretty warm. So as I go through the workout, my warm-ups are going to be less and less because I don't really need it. I mean, that's the point of a warm-up is to, you know, get your body primed for the main movement. So since I'm already feeling warm right now, I'm going to probably only do like one or two warm-up sets on here. And then I'm going straight to my top set. Yeah, see on that one it was only two reps and then like just to feel the weight. I'll probably get one rep right here, then I'll go straight to my top set. But same thing on this one. I'll go top set, and then my goal is like anywhere from like 6 to 10 reps, and then I'll go back off set after that. And my back off set, I'm trying to get a little bit more volume in, so anywhere from like 12 to 15 reps. But
two sets. That's really all I need on this anyways. Just like two hard sets and then done. Go to the next workout.
I for sure need my belt on this one. I learned my lesson about not wearing a belt because I got like a slight hernia. So
pretty much any time I'm doing any type of like heavy movement, I'm wearing a belt just to protect myself. Yeah, see that? That felt super smooth, so I'll go to my top set now. I don't know, some workouts you just feel stronger than others. And so I know my last quad and ham day, when it came to RDLs, like 315, I picked it up and it felt super heavy. Like as soon as I lifted it off the rack, I was like, oh, like this shit feel heavy. But today, that first rep, like I picked it up and it's super clean. So I know for sure I'll be able to get, I'm aiming for like the top side of the rep range, which is 6 to 9. So I'm aiming to get like hopefully 8 to 9, but we'll see. All right, top set right here. Got that 21 on. Dang. That was 7. I really wanted 9 on that one, but it is what it is. That one actually felt heavy though. As soon as I picked it up, it felt heavy. I probably should have went from 315 to like 365 and then 415. But something for me to note for next time, because I feel like I for sure would have got 9 if I was a little bit more warmed up. But like I said, it is what it is. But I still beat my previous best last time by one. Cause I hit six last time, so. And my form was, it was very good, so. I can't complain about that at all, but. So now, I'll catch my breath and I'm gonna go back all set. I don't know if y'all can hear me, but I'm breathing hard as hell right now. I'm honestly probably, for back offset, I may go 2 plates and really focus on the squeeze and the stretch. I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm gonna really focus on like the stretch right here. I'm gonna just go 2 plates. Even though I probably could do 315, I feel like that I wouldn't be able to get like much reps. I would have to take like a 5-6 minute rest break and I don't have the time to do that. So I'm just gonna put it down to 225, that way I could still get good reps and then kind of stretch out more on this one. All right, here we go, top set. Also, I'm gonna put the weight down in my feet and then pick it up from the plates. This is way safer than picking the weight up and walking backwards with it. I think I got like 9 or 10 on that. Again, I wanted to get like 12, but I would have, my form would have broke if I would have got 12. So, like I said, that's a key thing to remember. It's not always about just reps. Like, you want to make sure you got good form too. Because I for sure could have got 12, maybe even 15 reps, but my form would have been horrible, so. All right, on to leg press. I used to never really be able to connect with this movement, but ever since I kind of like switched my form, I started doing it more, like focusing less on the weight and focusing more on form and
feeling it in the actual muscle. It's been a lot better. Like, and honestly, I would say that I feel this probably more than any other leg movement now in my quads, just because of, just from the form aspect alone. Again, I'm probably just gonna go one warm-up set right here. I like to at least do just one warm-up set, just so I could get a good feel for the machine. I know some people, like, once they're warmed up all the way, they just go straight into, you know, whatever exercise they got next, they go straight into it. But I'm just like scared of doing that because I feel like I could get more out of it if I at least just do one warm-up set, just like one or two reps. And, you know, I could get used to the machine, get used to the weight, and then go straight into my top set from there. Just to get a feel for the weight. Oh yeah, it feels good. So one thing I didn't even notice was my seat is, it could go down lower. So I'm actually have it right there. I'm gonna try this weight and then see how it feels. Normally I do have it all the way back, but I just forgot to check it this time. Like, a lot of people probably gonna look at this weight and be like, what this man doing with only four plates on? I'm telling you, like, I've been focusing a lot more on just form and actually feeling my muscle, and this worked way better for me than just throwing on a ton of weight. Because, like, if I wanted to rep out like eight plates, I could, but that's not the goal. Like, the goal isn't to come in here and just ego lift and, you know, show off how strong I am. The goal is to build muscle. Like, that's the primary objective. At least that's my objective. I don't know. Your objective may be different, but mine is to build muscle and build as much muscle as I can without risking injury or my recovery taking forever. So I noticed that less weight, focusing on form, I still am going to failure, and I'm not being able to, like, basically, like, I'm still able to go to failure with this, and it's not like I'm doing 50 reps. Like, I'm doing slow controlled form and maybe getting like 12 to 15 reps with this, which lets me know that before I was just moving the weight just to sling weight around. I wasn't really like working the muscle, which, like, you will grow from that, but you will sustain a lot more injuries. Your recovery is gonna be a lot longer. You're just gonna feel fatigued. Like, that's fine if that's like, if that works for you and that's your training style. But ever since I've switched to this type of training, which, like, I recently did once I started back bodybuilding, it's been a world of difference. And I like this style of training way more. And just easier on my joints too. But yeah, so weight isn't everything. As long as you're going to failure or close to failure, that's what's gonna build muscle. Your muscle doesn't know that you got 20 plates on the leg press. It's not gonna be like, oh, you got 20 plates on here. Okay, I'm gonna grow now. It's all about intensity and how intense you are and how close to failure you can get with your exercises. All right. Thanks for coming to my TED Talk. Here we go. Oof. Oof. Oof.
I'm not gonna lie. That one for sure took it out of me. Like I said, I got four plates and a quarter, a 25 on here. Like, now was like, that was a tough set. Like, that was tough. So weight isn't everything. And my quads are on fire right now. But yeah. And guess what? I also don't have to worry about my knees hurting in the morning because I just did heavy weight, just went through the repetitions. So, oh man. All right, I got one back off set here. I'm gonna lower the weight a little bit. And then same thing, I'm going to a failure. Take a second on this. Yeah, like my quads right now, like they are super pumped right now. I pretty much consider this starting over because before, like I said, I was just hitting the weights just to hit the weights, like just repping out, you know, just moving weight just to move weight without being intentional with my training. So now that I'm intentional, the weight, I'm not able to get the same amount of weight, but I'm slowly building it up over time. Cause I started out on this with just three plates. And now I've worked myself up to a plate and a quarter. And so after that, it'll be five plates. After that, it'll be six plates. Then, you know, seven plates. And it's just like, then my quads will really be growing because not only will I have good form, but then I'm also able to push a good amount of weight. Rather than just me, you know, not getting full range of motion and quarter repping or half repping. That's not how you grow at all. You can, let me rephrase that. That's not the best way to grow. You can grow from that, of course, because I've done it. I've been training like that and I've grown from it, but you can see more growth. And even if it's the same amount of growth, I promise you, you will have less injuries. So just food for thought. Mm.
That was another good set.
Oh man, I felt that.
I'm gonna hit three sets on this just to get whatever else left I can, like out of my legs. And then that's it. Well, two sets. So I'm gonna hit one more. Depending on how I feel after this one, I may do another set, but it just depends. All right. All right, here we go. Hey. Oof. 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 No joke. All right. That was the last set, so I'm gonna go straight into seated leg extensions now. And then abs, and that's it. Here we go. Oh yeah, that's better. Oof. I'm not gonna lie, this leg day, it took it out of me, for real. That's why it's good to, like, if you're training intense, you can't do like 50 sets of an exercise or 50 sets in one workout. It's just, you're not training hard enough if you're able to do that much volume. I would even say over the course of a week too. Like, if you train intent, you come in, you stimulate the muscle, you put as much focus on the muscle that you're trying to train, good form, you don't need that much to be able to grow. A lot of people just like, they just try to go straight to add in more volume, when like volume may not even be the issue. It could be form, it could be the exercise choice that you have. Maybe it's not a good exercise for you. There's a lot of other things that like can equate to a body part not growing, or growing as intended or growing fast enough. But a lot of people just like to look at volume, like, oh, I need to do more volume. Oh, I need to do more sets. Oh, I need to lift heavier weight. That must be the thing. And that's not necessarily the case. So just food for thought. Like, if you're having a muscle part that struggle growing, look at all the other markers. Like, are you getting enough sleep? Are you eating enough? Is your diet on point? Make sure that your exercise choice and selection, it makes sense. Like, if you're trying to grow your quads and on your leg days you're hitting hamstrings first, that doesn't really make sense. You want to prioritize those body parts that are your weak body parts and that you want to grow while you're the freshest, because they get the most, the most attention in the beginning of the workout, because as you go through the workout, you're going to get more tired, your body's just going to get more fatigued. So you got to prioritize those weak body parts first, get those done and out the way, and then you can go on to the other, body parts. That's it for legs. My legs are done. About to go on to abs now. I was gonna do cardio after this workout, but I think I'm gonna just wait till tonight, because I need to go home and eat. Also, this incline is way too steep. That's crazy. Whoever doing the incline that rough steep, they got some titanium abs for sure. Ooh. All right, I'm gonna do a little physique update. I don't know how this is gonna turn out because it's kind of dark over here, but